In this video, we will see how we can track our calls on snapoptions.com. So if you are using covered call strategy and if you have done covered call transaction, you know it is very important to get the adjusted cost after getting premium, so you know how much you have recovered using premium or how much premium you have collected over the time for your holdings. So in this video, we will see how we can track different aspect of covered calls on snapoption.com. I used to track covered calls using spreadsheet, and now I moved all my portfolio to snapoptions.com because it makes tracking covered call much easier. So let me show you my Excel sheet first. Okay, so this is how I used to track covered calls. So each symbol I have separate sheet, and in that sheet I will write down how many stocks I bought at what price, and then how many contracts I sold at what expiration date, what is the strike, and what was the premium per contract. So based on that, we can see altogether I have collected $1,128 on 300 shares, and my total investment was 8,837. My average cost was 29.46, and after premium recovery, my adjusted cost is 25.70. So let's add this information on snapoptions.com. The first thing we need to do is add these 300 shares. Now, I did not record the date for the purchase, date of the purchase. So we'll just go by just one specific date. So first covered call I see was done, where it has the expiration of February 12th. That means all these stocks were bought before February 12th. So let's assume we bought all those stocks in January. So we'll add those transactions. So let's go back to snapoption.com and look for LI. So once you come to the page for LI Auto, you will see all different information. Now this information based on the all the transaction you have added. So first thing we need to do is we need to add 300 shares. Now we can do individual three transaction, or we can just do one transaction for $300 and bring the adjusted cost to 29.46 to make things easier, but we'll do three separate transactions just to show how the snap option works. So let's go to bought, and we'll say I bought 100 shares and my price was 31.40, and the date, the purchase date was, let's say January 6th. Okay, so I will click on add. Now I have added 100 shares at 31.40, so I'm gonna add another 100 shares. So I bought another 100 shares. The price was $30.76. So $30.76. Let's say we bought that one on January 12th. And now we'll add another 100 shares at 26.21. So we'll go per bought. I bought 100 shares at 26.21. And let's say this one we bought, on the 15th. Click add. Now we have all 300 shares added. Our average cost is 29.46. So we are good to go as far as the holding goes. So this part is already in the system. Now let's start working on this part. So the first time we did covered call for LI Auto was somewhere before February, and the expiration date was February 12th. So let's open a new covered call. So click open covered call. Now, by default, the expiration dates are all the active expiration date, or one that were not expired. Now, since I'm recording video in June, I don't see any previous expiration date. So to add the past expiration date, what I will do is I will click on custom. That will give me the option to change the date. So once I click on this one, I will see the expiration date was February 12th. We did 3 contracts and average received was 76 cents. So I will say I received 76 cents. Now here I will change the transaction date to, let's say we did this transaction was, let's see, what was the date? Let's say we did on 26th. So January 26th, we sold 3 covered calls and the expiration date was February 12th. The strike was $34. The premium we received was 76 cents. And let's hit submit. And as you can see, we received $228 premium. Right here, we can see the total here. We received $228. Our cost got adjusted. Instead of $29.46, which was our average cost, now the adjusted cost is $28.70. All right, so what we did after that? So after that, we rolled those February calls into March call. We lowered the strike to 30 and we received 80 cents for that. So let's now to view all the covered calls, we will click on view covered call. This will give us all the open covered calls we have. Now we did only one transaction that had 3 covered calls, and that was started on January 26th. So let's open that. And now we see the transaction right here, which was $34 call, February 12th expiration date. We sold 3 at 76 cents. Total we received was $228. So what I want to do is I want to roll this transaction to March. So I'll click on this 3 dots. It will give me option to roll. Now once I roll, I will choose the new dates. Now the new date was February 19th, so I'll click on custom. We'll go back to March 19th. The date was, a strike was 30, and for that we received 80 cents. And let's say we did transaction right before the previous call expired, so it was expiring on February 12th. So let's say we did that transaction on the 10th. So on the February 10th, we rolled February 12th covered call to March 19, lowered the strike from $34 to 30, and for that we received 80 cents. So let's click submit. So once I submit, you can see now our total recovery by covered call is $468. Now let's add next transaction. So now we are going to add the April transaction. For that, we received 35 cents. So I'll go back to view covered call. Click on detail, and I see that's March 19 covered calls. I'll click on action, roll, and now we will roll it to April 1st. Strike is 30. For that, we received 35 cents. And let's say we did that. We rolled the transaction right before the expiration date, so on March 18th. And I will hit submit. Now you can see our record by covered call is $573. So let's add the next transaction, roll the April transaction to May. For that we receive 10 cents. So we'll go to view covered call, click on detail, and let's roll this transaction to May 21st. Same strike, received 10 cents. And let's say we did that transaction on March 31st. Hit submit. And now we'll add the June transaction. So let's view covered call, detail, roll, we will select June 18, same $30 strike, and we got 90 cents. So we got 90 cents, and we roll that one on May 19th, hit submit. You got 873. Now let's roll for July 16. So you go to view covered call, click on detail and roll. We are rolling it to July 16 and we got 80 cents. 80 cents, we did that one on, let's say June 17 and submit. Okay, so as you can see, our record by cold call is $1,113. We'll go for view cover call. We will see the detail here. And we have the last transaction. Okay, so last transaction was for July 16. And we received 80 cents. All right, so our total recovery is 1113. We can see here, 1128. Okay, so there is a difference. Let's see where we made a mistake. Okay, so we did 80 cents. Actual transaction was 85 cents. So let's just go back action and edit this contract. We'll keep everything same. We will just change it to 85 cents. We'll just change the price and we will submit. And now we can see our recovered by covered call amount is 1128 and our adjusted cost is 2570. So as you can see, our adjusted cost is 2570. So let's go back to view covered call and we see more details over here. So as you can see here, we started this covered call on January 26th with three contracts. At that time, our average cost was $29.46. Our average strike right now is $30. So that means if the calls get exercised, we will get at least $30. The expiration date right now is July 16. Total investment was $88.37. Total recovery is $11.28. So we recovered 12%, and our adjusted cost is $25.70. All right, so we'll go back to detail. And you can see it will show you all the transactions that you did. So we did, the new position we opened was on January 26th. That was February 12th call. And then we rolled February 12th to March 19th, March 19th to April 1st, April 1st to May 21st, May 21st to June 18th. And with each transaction, how many contracts we used in that roll, what are the price that we got, so the premium we received. So as you can see, the profit, it's right there. So right now our fee structure is zero, that's why we don't see any fees here. But you can go to your portfolio and change the option fees if your brokerage is charging you any option transaction fees. All right, so let's see what other options are available on covered calls. So there are a few things available. First thing is you can close it. So let's say if you got exercised, let's say if the call expired worthless and you want to close it, so you can just close and set the price to zero and you can close the transaction. That what that will do is closing the transaction will release your stock, your 300 stock, because right now your 300 stocks are used as collateral. So that means you cannot sell these stocks right now. So if you go and try to sell the stock, let's say you want to sell five stocks at $31, and it will give you a message saying you do not have enough LI stocks in your portfolio. So because your stocks are held as a collateral for your covered call. So now we also have other option here, reverse. Let's say if we made a mistake, let's say if you want to reverse this transaction, right? So if you reverse this transaction, I will say, okay, you are reversing this transaction. Click submit. It says, And now we got a message saying you do not have enough stock to reverse this trade. Now let's see why. So let's go back. And as you can see, we have this covered call open, which has three sold positions. That means you already have 300 stocks and a collateral. So if you reverse that one, that means it will open one more transaction with three more contracts. That means you'll have six contracts, which you cannot do because you do not have enough stock. So in that case, if you want to reverse the transaction, what you will do is first delete this transaction. So we'll go to action and also delete this transaction. Once you submit, option deleted. And if you go to view covered call and we'll go to detail, you can see there is no open contract and you have 300 stocks as a collateral. Now we can reverse it. So we'll go to reverse and hit submit. And now you can see our stocks as a collateral is back 300 and the transaction got reversed and the expiration is set back to 6/18. So if you go to detail, you can see that June 18 transaction is now active. So let's go back and just roll that to normal. We have is July 16, 30, and for that we saved 85 cents. And we'll say we did that transaction on June 17 and submit. So now we are back to 11/28. So this is how you do covered call on snapoption.com.